Hello and welcome to the OWC instructional series of videos. In this installment, we'll be replacing the hard drive in an early 2011 13-inch MacBook Pro. We've already transferred our data to the new drive, gathered our materials, shut down the MacBook Pro, and have placed it on a soft, static-free work surface. We are now ready to begin. The first step is to close the MacBook Pro and flip it over. On the bottom are 10 Phillips screws. The three on the upper right are longer than the others, so remove those first. You can now remove the remaining 7 screws, which are all the same size. Once the screws are removed, you can lift the bottom off. The hard drive is located here. First, though, we need to disconnect the battery connector, which is located here. Use a nylon pry tool to gently lift the connector free from the logic board. Once it's disconnected, we can then safely remove the hard drive. To detach the hard drive, we must first remove the retainer bar, which is held in place by these two screws. Once you've removed the retainer bar, lift up on the plastic tab to pull the hard drive out of the bay. Then, gently detach the SATA connector. On the hard drive, there are 4 Torx T6 mounting pins which we'll need to remove. Once that's done, gently peel off the plastic tab. You can now set the hard drive aside and prep the new drive. You can install either a standard 2.5-inch SATA hard drive or a 2.5-inch solid-state drive in the drive bay. For this installation, we're installing an OWC Mercury Extreme Pro SSD. Hold the new drive face up with the SATA connector facing away from you. Then, rotate it 90 degrees counterclockwise. Attach the plastic tab on this edge by pressing it firmly against the drive. There should be enough residual adhesive to allow it to stick. Next, attach the 4 Torx T6 mounting pins to these 4 holes. The new drive is now ready to install. Line up the SATA connector on the drive with the connector on the MacBook Pro and gently slide the two together. Slide the two pins closest to you into the grommets on the MacBook and angle the new drive so it lays flush in the bay. Replace the retaining bar and tighten the two screws. You may now reattach the battery and put the bottom cover into place. Reinsert the bottom screws, starting with the longer 3 in the upper right corner. Then, replace the remaining 7 screws. You may now flip your MacBook Pro over, open it up, and turn it on.